BestBookBits.com brings you Expert Secrets, Section 3, 10X Secrets. Section 3, 10X Secrets, one-to-many selling. When you are selling face-to-face, you have the unique ability to ask specific questions, get personal feedback, and resolve objections on the spot. When you're in an event or selling inside a funnel, you can't really ask questions and get answers from thousands of people, so you need to create your presentation in a way that resolves all the objections that will come up for as many people as possible. Your platform and your funnels are your virtual stage. You will use them for your ads, the landing pages for your funnel, your live and automated webinars, your Facebook and Instagram lives, your YouTube videos, your podcast, and more. The way you structure your selling presentations on these platforms are the same as how you structure a sales presentation from stage. Plugging in your offer and stories. Figure 11.1, you'll plug in your Stack Slide and Epiphany Bridge stories into the perfect webinar framework. Secret number 11, the perfect webinar framework. What I've discovered from the best people in the business was that teaching the best content hurts sales. But learning how to identify, break, and rebuild false belief patterns gets people to take the actions they need in order to change. I learned how to tell stories, how to structure offers, and so much more. The framework. Figure 11.2, the perfect webinar framework has three main parts: the big domino, the three secrets, and the stack and closers. The framework revolves around three core phases: the big domino, the three secrets, and the stack and closers. When I have 90 minutes, the timeline looks like this. The first 15 minutes, intro, big domino, and origin story. Next 15 minutes, secret number one, the vehicle framework story. Next 15 minutes, secret number two, the internal beliefs story. And next 15 minutes, secret number three, external beliefs story. The last 30 minutes, stack and closes. If I only have 30 minutes, I break it down like this. For the first 5 minutes, intro, big domino, and origin story. Next 5 minutes, secret number one, vehicle framework story. The next 5 minutes, secret number two, internal beliefs story. And next 5 minutes, secret number three, external beliefs story. And the last 10 minutes, stack and closes. The ratios stay the same. You just expound longer on your stories and tell more short Epiphany Bridge stories to break more false beliefs if time permits. The big domino. One of the biggest things to understand is that the presentation is not about getting your audience to believe a lot of things. The entire presentation is designed to get them to believe just one thing, that your new opportunity is the key to them getting the result they desire the most. That's it. If you try to get someone to believe in more than one thing, your sales will suffer. Jason Flanlin once explained, the idea is to have a single point of belief that your message is built around and is emphasized over and over and over again from a variety of different angles. Your first attempt to knock down the big domino is by telling your origin story about how you discovered the new opportunity. This story will kick off the presentation, build rapport between you and your audience, and introduce them to the new vehicle that you will be presenting. The three secrets. This is the content section of your presentation. During the three secrets, you'll be teaching your frameworks. When you are teaching a course, you tell your story, explain the strategy, teach the tactics, and provide social proof. When you are selling, you do not teach the tactics. You teach the what, the strategy, but not the how. Your audience desires for the how is the reason they are going to give you money at the end of your presentation. Figure 11.3, when you're sharing your three secrets, you share the framework's name, Epiphany Bridge story, strategy, and social proof examples. The goal of each story, strategy, and the case study that you share is meant to break a specific false belief pattern and rewrite the story in your listeners' minds. You need to identify the false beliefs they have around the following. Number one, the vehicle, new opportunity. Number two, their ability to use the vehicle, which is internal beliefs. And number three, the number one thing they believe is keeping them from getting started, external beliefs. You will teach story, strategy, and case study for each of the three secrets. Figure 11.4, the three secrets are designed to break your customers' false beliefs and rebuild them into new beliefs so they're ready to take action with you. Stack in the closes. Here is where you move from the teaching the sales portion of the presentation. You'll then present your offer in a very precise format we call the stack. Figure 11.5, the stack and the closers will help you persuade people to act on your offer. Secret number 12, the big domino. My whole goal is to slow down and look around. Instead of looking for all the tasks that I could do, I try to identify the one big domino, the one thing that, if I could knock that down, all the other dominoes would either fall down or become irrelevant. The one thing, the big domino statement. How to knock down the big domino. Figure 12.2, in order to knock down the big domino, you can share your Epiphany Bridge story about how you discovered the new opportunity. Now that you've identified the exact thing you need your audience to believe if they're going to take action at the end of your presentation, it's time to design everything around rewriting the stories in their minds with new empowering stories that will better serve them. PowerPoint for PCs, Keynote for Macs, or my favorite, Google Slides, which works for everyone. The first 15 minutes or 1/6 of your presentation is trying to knock down the big domino through your origin story. We break this time down into two phases, the introduction and the origin story. Figure 12.3, your who what statement helps you quickly identify who you're serving, what result you can deliver, and what new opportunity you've created. I'm going to teach submarket how to result through your niche. Okay, we're going to go through the slides. Number one is the title slide. How to, without, the slide explains what your webinar is about. How to, the result they desire most, without, the thing they fear most. Slide number two, intro and rapport slides. These slides build rapport with your attendees. Confirm suspicion, encourage dreams, justify failures, ally fears, and throw rocks at the enemies. The third slide, the ruler slide. This slide explains who your new opportunity is for. The fourth slide, the big domino. This slide shares your big domino statement. Slide number five, qualify yourself slide. This slide shares your backstory and qualifications. Slide number six, Epiphany Bridge origin story slides. These slides tell your Epiphany Bridge origin story. Figure 12.10. To tell your Epiphany Bridge story, simply write down bullet points for each of the 14 steps, then start telling your story. Start with the backstory, then desire and your old vehicle, and then go through your journey, which is the call, the villain, the what if, then the new opportunity, which is the guide, epiphany, new opportunity, and then the framework, strategy, your results, and then others' results, and then the achievement, external, and 13, what if. The transformation internal, and then number 14, how. Secret number 13, the three secrets. Figure 13.1, if the big domino doesn't fall over, you'll need to break other false beliefs your audience has. Step number one, identify their three core false beliefs. Figure 13.2, your prospects will have false beliefs about the vehicle, their own ability to use it, and external influences that will stop them from having success. The vehicle. Other false beliefs they may have about the vehicle, framework, or new opportunity you're presenting. Internal beliefs. Beliefs about how their own abilities to execute on the new opportunity. External beliefs. False beliefs they have about outside forces that could keep them from success. Things beyond the individual's control, such as time or the economy. Step number two, write three Epiphany Bridge stories. Now that I have the three core false beliefs, I have to find the Epiphany Bridge stories that will break their core chains of beliefs and create new story for them. Step number three, write three secrets. Finally, I rewrite each of the false beliefs with an accompanying Epiphany Bridge stories into a secret using a how-to statement that hints at my framework being the key to their desired result. Breaking and rebuilding belief patterns. Everything you've done to this point has been designed to encourage curiosity, build rapport, and introduce the new opportunity. Now we're transitioning to the content section of the presentation. You'll be tempted to switch into teacher mode at this point, and if you're not careful, it will destroy your sales. This is not a teaching presentation. This is a presentation to inspire people to take action and change their lives. You can teach the strategy, what they need to do, but not teach the tactics, how they need to do it. Figure 13.4, in your perfect webinar, you'll teach the framework strategy, the what, not the tactics, the how. Teaching the tactics is what you do after they have purchased. If you do teach the tactics, it's the surest way to kill sales. You must change their beliefs about your strategy first, then you can change their lives. You must change their beliefs about your strategy first. Then you can change their lives. But if you don't change their beliefs first, you'll never have a chance to change their lives. The greatest service you can provide for someone is getting them to buy something. The act of buying creates a commitment that causes someone to take action. Number 7, transition to the 3 secrets slide. Introduce what you're going to teach during the webinar. The slide lists the 3 secrets. Slide number 8, state secret number 1. This slide states the first secret to break false beliefs about the vehicle. Introduce your first frameworks, the vehicle. Figure 13.7. When you share your framework for the vehicle, it's the same framework you've discussed in your Epiphany Bridge origin story, where you explain how you discovered a proprietary framework to succeed with your new opportunity. Figure 13.8, you'll introduce the vehicle framework's name, share the Epiphany Bridge story that you learned or earned, teach the strategy, the what, and share social proof and examples. Slide number 9, introduce the framework slide, the vehicle. This slide introduces the framework's name. Slide number 10, share learned or earned story slide, the vehicle. This slide shares the Epiphany Bridge story that you learned or earned. Number 11, teach the strategy slide, the vehicle. These slides teach the strategy, the what of the framework. If you spend time in the weeds teaching the tactics here, you will lose them. Once again, your only goal is to get them to believe the strategy will work for them. After they believe, then you can teach them the tactics inside your training. Slide number 12, case study. Figure 13.12, these slides share case studies of people who've had success using your framework. Slide 13, share other supporting Epiphany Bridge story slides. These slides break other related false beliefs. Go back to the list of false beliefs you created in your story inventory. Find the ones associated with the secret and quickly break the false beliefs that may be holding your followers back. These stories are usually told in 30 to 60 seconds. Just mention the false beliefs and give a quick story in a few sentences about why that belief is wrong and what the truth is. Number 14, introduce your second set of framework, internal belief slides. After you've finished secret number 1, you'll follow a similar flow for secret number 2. The only difference is that you'll be sharing your Epiphany Bridge story about your internal frameworks. 15, introduce your third set of frameworks, external belief slides. After you finish secret number 2, you'll follow a similar flow for secret number 3. The third secret is all about your customers' external false beliefs. Secret number 14, the stack and closers, stack psychology. The only things prospects remember when you sell is the last thing you show them. Figure 14.1, by adding your offer elements one at a time on the same slide, you allow your prospects to see the value build in front of their eyes. When you transition to the close, you're going to walk people through your offer. You do this by introducing the first part of your offer, telling the story behind how you created, learned, or earned it, and listing that one thing on a slide with the total value. You'll then move to the second element of your offer. Tell the story about how you created, learned, or earned it, and come back to the stack slide and show elements number 1 and 2 with the new total. Figure 14.2, by keeping all offer elements on one slide, you allow your prospects to associate the price of your offer with all the elements combined instead of just the last thing you said. The stack and close slides. Figure 14.3, after you share the big domino and the 3 secrets, you'll transition to the stack and closers. Number 16, the transition to selling slide. This slide recaps everything your audience has learned. When you sell in person, you have the ability to ask follow-up questions and figure out their specific false beliefs. Then you can address those concerns and close them. You don't have the luxury in one-to-many sales like webinars or inside your funnels, so you have to include as many objections and false beliefs in the presentation as possible. Number 17, the question slide. This slide asks for permission to share something with your audience that will help them. The best way to make that transition is to simply say, "Let me ask you a question." Number 18, what you're going to get slide, the core product. This slide shows the core product and service you're selling. Number 19, you'll be able to get rid of slides. This slide shows the core product or service you're selling. Number 20, the problem this product solved for you slide. This slide shows the roadblocks you run into when you try to get the same desires your customers want. Number 21, how much time and money this product will save them slide. This slide tells them they will save time and money by using your product or service. Number 22, break related beliefs about the product slides. These slides break other false beliefs they may have. 23, stack slide 1. This slide lists the value of your core product and service. 24, introduce element number 2, the framework slides. These slides explain the framework they'll also receive. 25, quick high-level recap of deliverable slides. This slide goes through a quick outline of what they'll receive with the framework. 26, case study slides. These slides share case studies of people who found success with your frameworks. 27, who this works for, all-inclusive slide. This slide reminds them who your offer is for. 28, destroy the number one reason people don't get started slide. This slide breaks down any objection to starting right away. Number 29, stack slide number 2. This slide adds the value of your framework to your offer. Number 30, repeat this process for all other elements of your offer. Introduce other elements of your offer by sharing the pain and cost it took you to learn and earn them and the ease and speed they'll get by using them. Stack slide number 3, this slide goes after each element you introduce so they can see the total offer value rise. 31, the big stack slide. This slide shows your entire offer with the total value. 32, if all statement slides. These slides compare the price to the value of the result they'll receive when they buy. If all statements, and if all statement reads like this. If all these packages did was X, would it be worth X amount of dollars? Now, obviously, I'm not going to charge you $11,500, but if I did charge you $11,500 and all it did was X, would it be worth it to you? Now, when you discount the price to what you're actually selling it for, they are getting a 90% discount from what they believe and have said it's worth. Number 33, I had two choices slides. This slide explains you could price it low or require a higher investment. 34, what would the end result be worth slide? This slide asks how much the end result is worth. 35, price drop slide. This slide drops the price from the value amount to the retail amount. 36, price reveal slide. This slide reveals the price for attendees. 37, price justification slide. This slide justifies the price compared to the retail price or the cost to get similar results. 38, you've got two choices slides. This slide explains that they can do nothing or they can test it out. Number 39, guarantee slide. This slide reverses the risk and explains your guarantee. Number 40, the real question is, this slide explains that even if they does only half of what they've claimed, it will pay for itself soon. Number 41, the last stack slide. This slide recaps each element to show the entire offer. 42, urgency and scarcity bonus slide. This slide shows a time-sensitive or number-specific, or both, bonus to push them to act. The two most valuable tools in your marketing are urgency and scarcity. Here you're going to add a bonus upgrade that's only available right then. You can create urgency and scarcity by offering something special to a certain number of people or for a certain amount of time, or both. Number 43, closing call to action, Q&A slide. This slide stays up during your Q&A session. Secret number 15, trial closes. Trial closes and mini closes will help persuade attendees to buy your offer. Here are some examples of trial closes. Are you ready to get started? Are you getting all of this? Is this making sense? Can you imagine if this happened to you? Who here wants a free copy of? Would you like to be our next case study? You've heard them talk about this before, right? Isn't that cool? Isn't that exciting? Am I right? Can you see yourself doing? I'm sure you've noticed this too, right? The most powerful times to use trial closes are right after you shared a case study or a success story from one of your students. Many times people will share their story and then quickly move on. If you notice, when Russell shares any story, he will always pause and then drop half a dozen trial closes before he moves on. Do you hear that? Isn't that amazing? Can you imagine what your life would be like if that happened to you? Are you getting this? These are all examples of the types of trial closers Russell would use right after sharing a success story. 16 mini closers. Money is good. The goal is to get people to disassociate from their fear about spending money with you. Money is a tool for exchange. You spend money to get something greater in return. Disposable income. The goal is to help them realize that they are spending their disposable income on things that aren't serving them well. And by spending the money on things that will help them grow, they will have long-term fulfillment. When you use the disposable income close, people get that they do have the money to invest. Money replenishes. The goal for this close is to help people realize that while each month money comes back, time doesn't. And if they're not careful, they will run out of time. Break old habits. The goal for this close is to help them realize that if they leave today without investing, nothing in their life will change. Information alone. My goal for this close is to help them understand that while they have gotten some awesome information, they can't rely on information alone. They need coaching and accountability too. Money or excuses. The goal of this close is to get them to quit making excuses about why they can't buy. Your two choices. The goal of this close is for them to understand why you were charging so much money and to make sure they're okay with that. Their two choices. The goal for this close is to help them realize they are crazy if they don't invest with you today. Us versus them. The goal for this close is to call people out as either doers or dabblers. The handhold. This close is where you walk through the sign-up process. Say goodbye. In this close, I want to show them all the pain that they will instantly disappear after they invest. Now or later. In this close, I want to paint a picture of their life now compared to what it could become if they invest. Only excuses. The goal of this close is to call out any excuses that might be keeping them back and diffuse them. Reluctant hero. The goal of this close is to help them believe they can actually do it. If you only got. The goal of this close is to show them that they already got for free and what they can possibly achieve when they invest with you. And last, the close. This close is the final push to get them over the edge. I typically do this one several times during the question and answer section at the end of the webinar. And that's a wrap on section 3, 10x secrets. Stay tuned for the last section, section 4, becoming your dream customer's guide. If you like this summary and want to listen to over 600 book summaries, check us out, Best Book Bits, on Spotify, Google Podcast, and Apple Podcast. If you're into the video book summary, check us out at Best Book Bits on YouTube. Subscribe, hit the notification bell, and you can watch over 600 video book summaries uploaded previously. If you're into the written book summary, follow us on bestbookbits.com, the home of the world's largest free book summary website in video, written, and audio format, where you can browse over 600 book summaries for free. Connect with me personally on Instagram at bestbookbits for daily motivational quotes and stories. Also, you can join me for our free book club in Facebook at Best Book Bits Book Club, so search that now and join. If you want the latest book summaries via email, pop your email in the link below. Thanks for watching and listening. Hope you got something from this Section 3 10X Secrets. Go out there, become an expert, and I'll see you soon. Take care. Bye-bye now.